You know how the Carol of the Bells goes?
No.
Okay. That's it. That's the one. That's the one. That's okay. That's the one. Very good. And you didn't raise your hand when I asked.
I know the second question usually is not great after the first.
Yeah. All right. So so we had like 8 tones of kind of Christmas music there to start us out with, which I'm going to get back to.
While this is all going on,
musicians from Ukraine are on tour across Europe and North America, playing, for example, in Carnegie Hall. The song which drew the most attention is the melody which was just sung, which was composed by a Ukrainian composer called Mykola Leontovich, which really caught the attention of the Americans, so much so that it was adapted with new English words to become what's now the Carol of the Bells, which is the most striking, I think, American Christmas carol, and I'm going to return at the end to why that is. Leontovich himself is murdered in 1921 by the Bolshevik secret police.
On
Sunday, I was at a concert in Carnegie Hall, which is not something I do all the time. You kind of have to make me, but I have kids, right? So, you know, you can imagine it was 3 hours long, right? But I really wanted to be there. It was very interesting. It was, among other things, the performers were the Ukrainian Children's Choir, which is called Shchedryk. And Shchedryk is named after a song called Shchedryk. But Shchedryk is an interesting word because Shchedryk involves an adjective which can mean both generous and bountiful, right? So like a person is generous, but a situation is bountiful, right? And that it's generous, that gives me a cue which I need to use to thank all of the Ukrainian historians and also the Ukrainian listeners. This class has turned out to have been listened to a lot of people in Ukraine. So I'm very glad that you've done so and that you've indulged my interpretations. But the blurriness between generosity and bountiful is interesting because it points us back to a pre-Christian era where in a pagan world, where like the deities are present in the world, there isn't really a line between generous and bountiful. Like the world is gonna be bountiful because the deities are generous, right? And that's why you perform certain rituals, and that's why you celebrate the season. So that song, the dun, 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 that song which we have as an American Christmas carol is of course, you know where I'm going with this, it's a Ukrainian song. And the reason why it's so different from all the American Christmas carols is because it arises from Ukrainian polyphonic singing, right? From multi-part harmony Ukrainian singing. And the song itself, the song that Mykola Leontovich took almost 20 years to adapt, is ancient. It's ancient. And it's not about winter, actually. It's actually about spring. Because if you're a pagan, I mean, if you're a sensible person actually living in the world, when does the year actually begin? It begins when things start growing out of the ground. And it begins when the swallows come and sing. It begins when the first lambs are born, which is February or March, which is what the song is actually about. It's about those things. So this song, which was adapted and played in Carnegie Hall a century ago and then played again on Sunday, is ancient. It's pre-Christian. It goes back before 988. It's actually about spring, right? It's about fertility, it's about prosperity, it's about love, it's about how things are going to get better, right? That part in the American version where they say at the end, like, Merry, 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 Merry Christmas, and that part of the song, they're actually, in the Ukrainian version, it's actually about how your wife is beautiful, right? Like, things are going really well for you, you're gonna make lots of money this year, the farm's going really well, and by the way, you know, your wife is beautiful. And what it literally says is that she's dark-browed, which is beautiful. That's a beautiful woman in Ukraine is a woman who has dark eyebrows. So it's a song about spring. It's a song which we think of as about winter, which is about spring, which I close on because I just want to suggest that sometimes that things that seem like an end can actually be a beginning.